Great. Well, in this video, what we're going to do is we're going to show how when you have a document that's signed through Zoho Sign, that it triggers through a workflow that will update the deal to closed one. Okay, that's what we're going to do. So the use case, you want to automate the process of updating a deal when the document is signed. So here's one of the things, it's not even on this right here, but one of the things we find is that the more you can let the systems do, then it's less you have to do, less you have to remember, less anxiety for you to remember it did. Okay, I sent the document out. Did we get that back? Has it been updated? Or are we going to do the next thing, which is fulfilling whatever it is that you sold? So this is one of those key things. If you can automate the fact that somebody signed the document and that triggers a workflow, which then updates the status of a deal, for instance, to closed one, which may go on a list for someone to take some other action on, great. And we can also trigger other things, right? Send an email notification to somebody. You can set tasks up for people. But we're not going to do that in this video. That's not the scope of this. But really, what we're going to show here is just the fact of how you, can you connect this? How can you build that little workflow, which takes like 5 minutes to do or less? We're going to do it in 5 minutes or less. How it can do that. So you don't want to remember. You know, have to remember everything. And then you may even want to go a step further after doing this and do what we've done before, which is another video on that. And that is from it, the signature happening on whatever that contract is or document you sent out, is that that can trigger to Zoho Books to create an invoice with that dollar amount and send off the invoice automatically. Again, that's not in the scope of this, but there's probably going to be a link somewhere on the page here of that video that we're doing. Oh, we've done. Anyways, what's the next thing here? Okay, what to do? We're going to create a workflow to update the stage to closed one, super easy. And then this is the thing, it's like a bonus thing that you want to see. Because one thing with Zoho that's kind of tricky is that if you have a process or a workflow that triggers off of a stage, a field update, then it won't trigger if the field update was done by another workflow. So what we're going to do is we're going to show you this twice. One, we're going to do it the basic way. So as long as you don't have any workflows that are triggering off the change of, let's say, the stage to closed one, then it's going to work fine. It's going to update the stage to closed one. But there's another video, which again, there's probably a link on this page here, that we go over how to automatically create a project when a deal is marked closed one. And you'll find that even though we have that workflow in place in the system already, it won't fire. It won't create the project until we add a little bit of code. We're going to create a function and we're going to add that to that workflow. That will then trigger that additional workflow. So I'll show you that. That's a really important piece. You're going to want to watch that. Okay, so let's go ahead and get started over here. Okay, so we're in an opportunity. If you don't have Zoho Sign connected to the CRM already, it's pretty easy to do. You just go into the tools here, go into Marketplace, search for Zoho Sign, and then you'll just install it. So look for Zoho Sign here, Zoho Sign for Zoho CRM. You're going to install it. I'm assuming at this point you've already done that. So you already have it in place. So when you're in an opportunity, let's say, come on. All right, in this opportunity right here, you have this button, Send for Zoho Sign. Maybe you've installed it, but never even worked with this. So what we're going to do now is we're going to look at sending for Zoho Sign. And we are going to use a mail merge template that I've already created in setup. So again, I'm going to kind of rock through this pretty quickly because I'm assuming you already know how to do this, or you're going to watch another one of our videos that shows you how to build these templates out. But you go into templates here. We've got a mail merge document right here. That's what we're going to use, this test signature document. Okay, it's done through Writer. Okay, so that's pretty quick because to bring you up to speed, that should look familiar to you because this is a little higher level one because we're talking about workflows and possibly even custom functions. So that's the template we're going to use for the signature. We already have Sign associated. Now we're going to look at the workflow. So the workflow we have created is this one called Signed. So let's go back to the opportunity again. I'm going to show you this. So the audience here that I'm talking to might be fairly advanced, might already be using Zoho Sign, others are not, so I don't want to leave you guys in a lurch here. So in an opportunity, if we look down here, wait, deal one, Zoho Sign documents, right? There's nothing in here. But the reason I bring this up is because you might think, okay, I'm sending the document through opportunity, that maybe the opportunity is the trigger for it. It's not. It's going to be the Zoho signed document. So this document isn't even, let's say you have a document in here. It's not this document. It's referencing this, but it's a special module within the CRM that captures what's happening with that document. So if it's been signed, if when it was sent, what the status of it is, that's what happens in Zoho Sign. So that's what we're going to use to trigger this. And you'll find here, if you look at this one called Signed, Zoho Sign Documents is what we're using, and we're using a field update. So when you go to create a rule, you're going to pick the module down here that is Zoho Sign Documents. Okay? Then you're going to name it whatever and put a description in. I've already done that. So now we're just going to go into it. So here we have, when do you want this to execute this rule? It's going to be on a field update of Zoho signed document when the date completed is updated. Because obviously it's going to be updated whenever that is completed. And that's what we want. That's what's going to fire this off. So the second thing is here is conditions. If you're not familiar with workflows, everything has a condition. You can send everything through. Every time a document is signed, it'll automatically run this particular workflow. Or you may not want it to run every single time because there might be certain conditions within Zoho signed documents that you might want to see. You know, if there's certain aspects of it that are filled in, you may not want every one to go through. For the sake of this, we're going to go ahead and keep the, yeah, change criteria. So all, we're just going to straight do it through all because of just the sake of time on this video. All right. So now what we're going to do is we're going to do a field update. So on action, the field update isn't going to be for Zoho Sign. What's nice about Zoho Sign, it has lookups to other things like accounts, leads, deals, right? So we're going to look here. I'm going to tap this, and here's the other options. And we're going to select deal. So now what we're going to do is we're going to create a new update, right? So if I do new update, I can fill this in, but I've already got it. So let me look at deals here. And we already have this one called update status. Okay? So just like you would have gone through those steps to do the same thing, which is put a name in, you're going to select the module, which is deal. We already knew that. And then the stage is going to be marked to closed one once it gets signed. Okay? So that's already associated. We're going to go ahead and save this. So when you're doing this, you already have the merge document all put together. All you need right now, potentially, is just to do that. Super easy, right? It takes you 2 minutes to come in here. Go to Zoho Sign Documents, say when that date completed is updated, and then do a quick field update. Super easy, okay? So this isn't rocket science. Okay, but now what we're going to do is go into that opportunity and we're going to demonstrate this. So send for Zoho Sign. In fact, let me back up here just a second. So the other piece that I mentioned is this other workflow right here. So this workflow, if we look at it, the opportunity to project, this is the other training that we did, is it showed how could you create a project automatically when something's marked closed. So if you see here, when the stage is updated to meet closed one, run this function here. Okay, so this is a workflow. I want to show you that because when we look at this opportunity, there's no projects here. Okay, and when we get this document signed, there's still going to be no projects there because it's not firing that second workflow. Okay, we're going to have to do that step a little bit later. So I'm going to go ahead and use the mail merge template. We've got this test signature document that I showed you earlier. We have the contact name in the opportunity, so they show up there automatically, right? And you could, for the people that haven't gone through the Zoho sign process, to demonstrate that, I'm gonna do this real quickly. You can go next, 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 and I'll show that. But otherwise, you could do quick send, and boom, it's sent off. Okay? But for those that, so you might fast forward or something. But for those that aren't familiar with Zoho sign, what it looks like when you click next, it does this. It confirms. Okay, this is the document. You could even change the name if you want to here to something else. And then you confirm, okay, that's who it's for. You can change the settings like time to complete it, agreement valid for whatever time, document type, folder. Okay. Set reminder every 5 days if they haven't signed it. Continue. It's actually going to show you what the document looks like. Here's the merge information that we have on that. And then here's the signature fields, signature and sign date. And this is who the recipients are, right? So now we'll go ahead and send it. All of those steps that I just did I could have just done quick send and it would boom, would have sent it off. The only exception is I wouldn't have been able to change the document name, right? So we'll give this a second and we should see an email pop up here in the upper right of my screen. Also, look at the sales signal here. You see these two? All right, let me open this up. Here's the email that just came through for this, right? And let me go back over here and I'm going to show you again what the stage. I should have probably highlighted that for you guys. It's registered. Okay, so once this is complete, it's going to be closed one. All right, so start signing. And probably what this is doing is opening up in my mail, like right here. Okay, so we're going to proceed the document. Yep, sure, it looks good. Okay, agree and continue. I'll sign this. I'll do the sign date. Okay, I've successfully finished. Okay, let's go back to this. And we'll give it a second here to feed in here. And you see there's no Zoho signed documents here yet, but when I refresh this, even if it's not marked closed one, it should show a document in there. And then we'll go on to the next piece. Okay, so that's just an email that comes through saying it was completed. You can see here is automatically marked to closed one, right? It went from registered to closed one. And the document down here, you can see I changed the name to something else, date completed, date sent. If you're not using Zoho documents, it's all brand new to you. You're not going to see all these fields here. You can just go over here and add whatever columns you want to see. Okay, again, that's kind of basic stuff. Now what we're going to do is we're going to revisit this workflow and we are going to add a piece to it. And it's going to be a function that I've already created. And you can see we'll include the code for you. Trigger workflow on signing of doc. We're going to associate that. We're going to look at it now real quick. So this little bit of code here, this is the key part. Trigger workflow. So what we need to do to bypass the fact, the limitation that you can't trigger, a workflow will not trigger on another workflow doing something, is that you have to do this. You have to write this little bit of code. So what I'm doing here is even though we already have that other field update, we won't need that anymore. We'll just use this instead. And what this does is it's changing the opportunity to closed one also. So stage is closed one. You may have to watch the other videos of what the structure of this is, but it's basically getting the record that's triggering this, the ID of that, okay, get the record by ID. Then we're going to do the deal ID, which is an extraction from that signed doc. As you can see here, the signed doc, get the deal ID. Then we're creating a map, and that's how most things are updated, if not all, when you're using the deluge scripting here, is that you're going to update the record that's a deal with the deal ID that we grabbed, and then we're going to update it with stage closed one, and then we're going to trigger the workflow so that it actually does it. Okay, so we're going to save this. This is the important part. So really, I could just remove the field status at this point. I don't need that. And again, the only reason why you'd use this other function is if you have other workflows that may not run because of this. Okay, so I'm going to save. I'm going to go back in just to make sure. Yep, both are in there. Okay. One thing to mention up here, too, is the sales signals. I'm not sure if you guys are using this, but you can see it shows that the document signed. So that's pretty cool. You get that kind of feedback. All right, so let's go back in this opportunity. I am going to change it back to, don't do that. Zutala. Come on. All right, go here to registered. Let's go back. Register. Qualification's fine. Okay, so it's changed qualification. It's not closed one. We're going to send the document again. This time I'm going to do a quick send so you can see that. Merging the document. That's why it's taking a little bit here. Okay, and we're just going to do quick send. So again, you don't see any projects over here just yet, but we should once this email comes through. the one we just got. Okay, proceed to document. It's got the merge information just like it did before, right? Nothing's changed there, but you can see that you didn't have to go through all those other steps of viewing the document. Okay, that's signed. So let's take a look over here. We'll give it a second. Might take a second for it to feed in. And we'll refresh this. Okay, it's marked a closed one, and it might just take a second for it to finally load in the projects, but that's gonna feed in there as well. Let me think what else is there. I think that's it. Let me just maybe real quick here show this. So keep that in mind. If you have a workflow that's triggering off of another workflow, it's not gonna work. Or if you do have one and all of a sudden you realize that it's not working, it's because you need to check that. So I had recorded all that, and then I realized that it hadn't created this project over here. So what I did is I went back into the setup here into signed, into that workflow that we had done, and I removed the other field update. So since there's no need for that, I should have done that earlier. And all I have now is the function that's actually updating that field and then triggering that workflow. Okay, so you have to remove that other field update if you do have that, and then confirming here that it did actually create the project that's associated with it. So if we go here, we can actually open up the project and it has the information. So watch the other video about that as well. But you should be good to go. Happy learning, and on to the next one, right?